Hello world, I'm Agitated Crane and I welcome you back to Star Trek Online. As you can see, we are in our wonderful ship, and what I wanted to do is take a look at research and development. Now, research and development is basically crafting, right? The way crafting works, you first should level it up. But as you have seen, I were collecting some resources. Now, why I did this? Obviously, because resources are important. But to craft, you are not using directly resources. You have to craft specific components first, and only then can you craft an item. Now, you can craft specifically what you want. You can craft a specific weapon type. It depends on the school, right? So beams, obviously beams, cannons. Engineering does, I think, mostly console, and oh, it actually does warp cores and impulse engines as well, and ground armor for some reason. Ground weapons is all about the weaponry. As you can see, there is a bunch of weapons available. Yeah. Kits are about kits. And I think we can craft all of it. Yep. We can craft even tactical modules and science modules, even though we cannot use them. So this is mostly about creating kit frame, and if we so desire, creating engineering module. Projectiles is about mines and torpedo launchers, as well as consoles associated with those weapons. Science is about deflectors, and shields is about shields. There is also officer training, which will create training manuals for which will create training manuals for our bridge officers to learn new abilities. And it is... Yeah. Why do I have... Yeah, okay, it's different. It's not the shields that we did not select. There are also special projects which require omega particles, which can only be obtained during special events, I believe. Now, the way crafting works, you select specific item. We like beam arrays, right? Then you can select the type of energy it will be. So we are currently doing phaser beam weaponry, and I think we will be sticking with them. Now, each energy type, it's not only color variation, it is also it has different effects. Anti-proton weaponry, I think, does the most damage. I may be wrong. I think I am wrong. Disruptor does, I believe, more damage to shields. Phaser does solid damage. And I think it also has a chance to knock out one of the systems. I'm not sure though. Let's check. Yeah, it has a chance to disable one random subsystem. So if I'm lucky, I can I can disable enemy ships by just firing weapons. Plasma does dot damage. Polaron, I don't remember what Polaron does. And Tetrion, I believe, drains shields faster. But no, that would be disruptors. Eh. No, Tetrion, I believe, goes through the shields. Like it has bleed through. And Polaron... What does Polaron do? Ah, who knows? And who cares, right? Then you can select the mark of the weapon. Now, you can go nuts and craft the higher quality. However, you will need higher quality components. And depending on your like skill level and who will be crafting, you get the chance of the quality of the weapon. It will also have random, what do you call them, weapon suffixes. I don't think we actually started getting them yet. Oh no, we do have, like that accuracy, see? Regulars don't have it. So very rare have like 3 or I think maybe even 4 additional suffixes, and there are stuff like more critical hits, harder critical hits, more damage or better accuracy. There is also I think shield penetration. There are some rare suffixes, but yeah. But also on I think level 10, maybe 15, you get a special weapon unlocked in beams and cannons and other weapon projects, and special shields, and basically each school has a special item that is unlocked on higher level. And to be honest, I don't think you should be crafting until you are on decent level. So until then, you do these research projects, which take 20 hours to complete, but they give you like insane amount of experience in the selected school. So I'm going to be honest with you, I'm not a fan of crafting in this game. While I do those research projects on most of my characters, because that's like a no-brainer, you just set it up and it will eventually do something, right? But like I never crafted anything from this system, and the fact that it has a bunch of randomized effects, I guess, is the word that I was looking for. And that can be applied to the item, to final item. I'm not a fan of those, so it's honestly, it's better to save money and buy whatever you want on the exchange, either from people that do specialize in crafting and like make insane amounts of money on it, or from people that just had lucky drops and don't need the item. So yeah, auction house is as always your best friend. So let's do research. At the start you can only do one, later you will be able to unlock more. But yeah, I'm not a fan of crafting. I will be passively doing it, but yeah. Let's continue with our missions. I'm coughing for some reason. Shadow play. Escorting a survivor back home leads the crew to discover the truth behind mysterious disappearance of Romulan in Romulan space. Oh, so we will be actually escorting that lady that we rescued.
Takela, the survivor you rescued from Demora Station, has provided some very interesting information about both the Tal Shiar and the new race with which they've allied. Meanwhile, the Romulan Republic and neutral colonies are continuing to report mysterious abductions. We believe these two events are related. Takela wants to go home to her colony on Serene Prime. The colony there has remained independent from both the remains of the Romulan Star Empire and the burgeoning Romulan Republic. That puts them in a delicate balancing act. We thought taking Takela home could be a good opportunity to figure out what's happening behind the scenes of the Romulan conflict. We would like you to go to Serene Prime and investigate.
All right, and we will be able to select plasma weaponry, which will be an upgrade for us, regardless of whether... regardless of it being a different energy weapon.
I have new missions.
Let's fly there. Auto-navigate. So this is a little bit strange because in the TV show you see that flying into not enemy but like different Empire space is like a huge no-no. But in this game it's no big deal. Romulans do not care that we are encroaching on Romulan Space Empire with our starships. And the new race that they were talking about, I do know who those are, because I played through Romulan campaign on my Romulan character. And yeah, that still, that Legacy of Romulus expansion, I think, is the best expansion that they ever did. Like, all the other expansions, like, for example, Delta Rising was fine, but it was, like, theme park. You visited basically all the planets that... not all, but, like, all the cool planets that appeared in Voyager and all the cool species that appeared there.
On a remote world, scientists are adapting Borg technology to suit their own needs. A Federation crew, caught in an impossible situation, fights to survive. But help may not arrive in time. Who will heed their desperate call? In their anguish, the Romulans could cause a greater tragedy than even they imagine.
I just remember that I did not read this flavor text on previous mission. But no one cares, right? The population of Serene Prime swelled to more than 4.7 million after the destruction of the Romulan homeworld. The Serene Council is now one of the most influential groups in the new Romulan Star Empire, and the Empress is scheduled to visit the world in the spring. Because of the increase in Serene Prime importance, the Romulan military has increased its presence on the planet. Alright. And we are not going to discuss other expansions. Just yet. Captain, we have arrived in the Serene system. This is supposed to be a neutral colony, but I'm detecting multiple Romulan Star Empire ships as well as a shield wall surrounding the planet. If this is a blockade, they are very serious about keeping people out. The warbirds are arming weapons, sir. We might have a fight if we want to return our guest to her colony. Okay. Speaking of which, Takela would like a word. Not world.
I can't thank you enough for returning me. It looks like the Romulan Star Empire has been busy while I was away. They were already lobbying our council to join them, but Romulan Republic envoys are there as well. Now the Empire is blockading the planet, probably to prevent information like ours from reaching our leaders. The shield wall is new. I guess the Tal Shiar constructed it. You should be careful.
For some reason I'm low energy today. It isn't the first time we run afoul of the Romulan Star Empire. I think I'm going to hail the Romulan vessel. But let's prepare weapons. Just to be sure. I love their blockade though. Oh, it's the Dereks. Okay.
This planet is protected by the Romulan Star Empire. State your business.
I didn't realize Serene Prime was a protectorate of the Romulan Star Empire.
Technically, it is not. However, the Empress has graciously extended her protection to all worlds in this region of space, including Serene Prime. There have been recent reports of terrorist activity on the planet. As a service to the lawful residents, we are securing the world against further intrusions.
Whether the Serenians like it or not, of course.
This planet is protected by the Romulan Star Empire. State your business.
I'm returning this citizen to her homeworld.
Indeed. Identify this citizen.
Let's lie. We did save her from Tal Shiar.
We have no record of that colonist. Lower your shields and prepare to be boarded.
Nope. No boarding. Oh. Firing, okay. You stay there. Although he has the same configuration as I do. Damn it. Better shields. Come on. More shields. More shields. Well, he is slowly dying, but not fast enough. Oh, that was great damage. Right there. Come on. More energy to weapons. Use tractor beams. Am I going to kill him? Oh wow, okay. And now we can enter planetary orbit. After killing thousands of people on that ship. Alright. Let's fly to the orbit. That blockade though. I wonder if this is even feasible to do in real life. Because how huge do you think this one cell is? Right? And you place the satellites and you place it all around the planet. Huh. Maybe those are not satellites, right? Maybe they are like probes. But then how many probes can one ship lay, right? Huh. Are you ready to beam down to the surface, sir? Yes, I am.
I can't believe I finally made it home. Thank you.
Sorry. I do not remember this mission.
I can't believe I finally made it home. Thank you. I never thought I'd see this place again. I would give you the grand tour such as it is, but I need to get back to my family. I never thought I'd see them again either. You should talk to a representative from our council. Follow the path ahead and it will lead you to our central square. There should be someone you can speak with there.
Welcome home. Seriously though, I don't remember this planet. And it looks cool. I like the planets on in Star Trek Online. Like they really do a good job, I think, of creating alien landscapes. Like even this, right? That like water. It doesn't look watery enough. It looks different. I mean, they can go crazier with this, I think. Previously, it used to be that there were zones in space which had like randomized content. It was like exploration zone, And there you would have, you would scan like star systems, I guess, and it would have random planets. And it would have either you would fight someone there, some aliens, or you have had to deliver some supplies there. Or, in fact, you had a planet to land on and explore. And the exploration consisted of mostly like finding something on or killing someone. So it wasn't like insanely interesting, but I enjoyed it, right? I don't need much, to be honest. And I liked it because it had randomized planets, right? So you would see those different landscapes. But they decided to remove it for some reason, and I'm not entirely sure why. I think, well, obviously, I think they see on their end what content is played and what is not, and I guess that content was not played that much by other players, so they just decided to cut it. It had like I think some achievements and missions associated with it, so it was almost like people were playing it because they had to, but they did not enjoy it, I guess. So, oh, what is this? A new ability. Cover shields. I think it creates... Yep, it creates this. Although, I'm not sure if I will ever use it. Like, you can hide behind that, but the game doesn't really have cover mechanics, so... Like, I guess you could hide behind it if you see that there is a huge attack coming. Who knows? So yeah, I hope they will introduce it back. Like they are working on a different version, because I really did enjoy exploring. I think we should be fortifying our military. Okay. I don't trust the Tal Shiar and all that stuff. Counselor Rehu.
Jolan Tru, and welcome to Serenity Prime. Oh, thank you for returning T'Challa to us. I'm sure her family is pleased she is safe. However, you have arrived at an interesting time. I was just preparing to meet with representatives from the Romulan Star Empire and the Romulan Republic. Each are urging our colony to join their faction. We've done our best to stay out of the conflict until now, but I fear we will soon be forced to take a side.
Yes, we met one of the Empire's representatives in orbit. They tried to destroy my ship. So, it's obviously portrayed like Empire bad, Republic good, right? And I'm not a fan of that. I think we should be focusing on the Empire more. And this mission, I think obviously it has a good ending, so they will eventually join the Republic, but I think it would be better if they did portray that, yes, Republic is actually a separatist movement from a rightful Empire, and that colony would join the Empire just to be like, yes, Empire is like the real government, and yeah, you can play with the Republic and try to build it, but it's not the rightful, I guess, regime, at least for me. The Republic, I feel like it just goes way too far away from Romulans, right? It almost becomes like puppet of Federation, and I'm not a fan of that. Yep.
Yes, the Empire has a way of offering assistance that feels more like a threat. They offered security services for my world, and I could not risk refusing them. And, to be fair, there have been no abductions since the fleet began protecting the planet.
Abductions?
A number of our citizens went missing in the weeks before the Empire arrived. The Empire blames the Republic, of course, but I think Sela likes to blame them for a lot of things. There's no evidence they are responsible, however. In fact, there's no evidence at all. And I think that if the Republic were behind these kidnappings, they would leave some trace behind. If you would care to speak to the representatives, I would be interested in hearing what your opinion of them is.
All right. So here is the one from the Republic.
A pleasure to meet you. What can I do for you?
What is your mission here?
My intent was to speak to the Council about the advantages of joining the Republic. Fortunately, I arrived before the blockade, and the Council has extended their protection to me. Otherwise, I'd probably be on my way to one of the Tal Shiar's prison facilities by now. The Empress likes to hide her threats in a few layers of deception and lies. It can be difficult for a peaceful world like Serene Prime to resist. But if we all stick together, we will be able to rise up and defeat the Tal Shiar once and for all.
Yes, ambitious goals, Subcommander. Good luck. And the Empire is here, represented by Tal Shiar. Okay.
You are not welcome here, Starfleet.
The Counselor feels differently. She asked me to speak with you and give her my opinion.
Then she is a fool. The Federation are allies of the terrorists who seek to destroy what remains of our glorious Empire. You will do nothing here but sow dissent and unrest. I also know that you destroyed a ship protecting this planet, with callous disregard for the safety of the citizens of this colony. I have nothing more to say to a murderer.
Well, I mean, no, we could have disabled the ship, but we chose to destroy it.
You had no choice. Those words have been the excuse of monsters since time immemorial. On the chance, however, that the Council is foolish enough to be swayed by your biased opinion, I will explain that the Romulan Star Empire is Serene Prime's only hope for peace and stability. We alone possess the military strength and operational effectiveness to keep this planet safe. The terrorists from the Republic can only offer them a portion of their own loss and suffering. The Empress has already sent ships to defend this colony. That is evidence of our intentions.
Your intentions are clear, Subcommander. I think I have heard enough. Now, I don't think we will have a choice, but if we do, I will actually side with the Star Empire. And hear my reasoning, right? Star Empire is still powerful, while Romulan Republic is quite weak. If the colony joins Star Empire, it gets protection of Star Empire. If it joins Republic, while it will get some protection, it will be weaker, and it will earn the ire of Star Empire, which is like bad. And I don't think Republic is strong enough to protect the colony if Empire decides to retaliate. On the other hand, if the colony joins the Empire, the Republic will not feel like it has to destroy the colony to show like show of force. Another thing, joining Republic, I don't know what this colony brings to the faction, right? Like, obviously it has people, and I think for Republic it's more like freedom and people and all that cool stuff. While on the Empire side, yeah, they will have I don't think this colony matters in the grand scheme of things. Like, it will not change the balance of power between Republic and Empire, right? Like, if it joins the Republic, yes, Republic will get, like, more citizens, but, like, it will get more citizens to feed, right? I don't think this, colony will probably, is probably able to sustain itself, and maybe it will even can send some resources to the Republic, but I don't think it's that much. While on the other hand, if they were under blockade by Empire, or if they had trouble, Republic would have to help, and Republic is already is strained with resources because it's like emergent government. While Empire, if colony was under the Empire, they will probably be paying something like taxes, but at the same time, if they will have issue, Empire will most likely help. And even if Empire doesn't help, Republic still could help secretly, and Empire will be just content that the colony is under their rule, and they will probably just forget about it because they have a bunch of colonies, right? Maybe for some time there will be probably like Tal Shiar presence, but eventually they will leave. And yeah, like the worst thing that could happen is a few people will go, will be recruited to Tal Shiar and maybe like forcefully recruited, right? And maybe they will also be like experimented on. Maybe. I don't think Empire will risk alienating the colony right away by stealing their citizens. Like, that would be silly, right? You joined the Empire, welcome! Now let us experiment on you. That's silly. I don't think they would do that. So yeah, I think the choice doesn't matter. But for the colony, it's best to join Empire than Republic. That is my reasoning. And now, let's talk to the Chancellor, who will not let us choose at all.
Well, what did you think of them?
Okay. You've done well, stay neutral so far. I don't see a reason. No, that's bad. I can't tell you what your colony should do. Follow your heart. This should be better, right? I think this is like the prime directive and what Starfleet stands for. But I think you should join a Romulan Star Empire.
An interesting perspective. Thank you for your suggestion. Our most convincing evidence comes from a survivor of Virenat. And if his story can be believed, he says he knows who is behind these abductions. You should speak to him before you leave. He's behind that building.
Well, okay, I will listen to his story. So yeah, they will force Republic on them anyway. Which is... okay. I don't agree with this. Like, the whole situation is, like, messed up. And I think, like, this is the kind of thing that people that like Star Trek actually like, right? They don't like space combat and all that stuff because the show was never about that. It was always about the diplomacy and tough choices. And I think this is... I think it would be better if we could make this tough choice here and let the colony join the Empire to protect the colony than to boost ego of the Empire. That's stupid. Speak to the survivor.
Yes. I was at Virenat. My family died there. My friends. It wasn't terrorists who destroyed my home, and it certainly wasn't the Republic. It was the Tal Shiar and their friends. But you don't have to take my word for it. Virenat has been abandoned since the attack. Go see what our Empress does to her people.
This is tough, right? I'm sorry for your loss. So obviously, like, Empire is portrayed like... I think they are portrayed like Nazis. I didn't want to say it like that flatly, but yeah, Empress is evil. The Tal Shiar is basically SS officers, but still, still. Like, let's look at the history of our world, right? It made sense to side against the Germany, because Germany, aside from being obviously evil, wait. Yeah, it makes sense to side against it. It was a small power. There were stronger powers. While you could argue that it grew, right? It had almost all Europe behind it, but it really didn't, right? It conquered the Europe, but the core force was still Germany, right? While on the Allies side, you had great powers like USSR and America and, you know, the guerrilla warfare in other countries. My history is bad, so bear with me if I'm babbling bullshit. Now let's say America decides to be Nazis, right? Instead of Germany, small Germany. All the countries around America are weaker, right? So, and the other force that is opposed to America is USSR, which is far away. So if you look at Mexico, like this colony, right? Obviously it would join America, because why would it join Russia that is far away when America can just destroy it on the next day, right? And I'm talking now about Cold War and potential of war, right? I'm not talking right the full-out war, and I'm also not talking about current day, but let's say like actual Cold War, where the travel is not fast enough and all that cool stuff, right? So even if Mexico does not agree with America, it is its neighbor, so it should side with it. Like the Cuba stuff, right? That was missile crisis. Again, I'm bad with history, but it sided with Russia, but not for long, right? Right now it's not friends with Russia. I don't think so. I'm not sure, of course. And as I said, I know more stuff about Star Trek than I do about real world, but like, think about it, right? If you are small, you don't have a choice in the matter. You can subscribe to that bullshit that a bunch of smaller pieces can form a stronger fist, right? The fingers form the fist, but that only works if you are surrounded by the fist and fingers. It doesn't work if you are on the other side of the galaxy, surrounded by the Empire. The Republic should be concentrating on colonies that are closer to... actually, we can look at the at that here, right? Here is Tal Shiar and here is the Republic. So okay, we are actually in the Republic space, sort of. Okay. This symbol is the Republic, right? And this symbol is the Empire and Tal Shiar. So actually this is closer to Republic. So actually, yeah, the argument that fingers form the fist is actually could be applicable here. Huh. But still, I still consider Republic to be weak and on shaky legs. So while this, again, it's that tough question whether this colony would benefit the Republic or will it just strain it even more. Who knows? We will see. It appears we have done all we can here, sir. Shall we return to the ship? Yes, beam up. This is going to be another long episode. Course locked in for Varinat. However, there are Romulan ships declocking. They're hailing us, Captain. On screen.
The Romulan Star Empire appreciates your support on Serene Prime. However, the evidence shows you had a role in the destruction of the IRW Rhea. I am afraid I need to ask you to lower your shields and prepare to be boarded. We must conduct a complete investigation.
Again? I'm also sorry, but I have no intentions of letting you board my ship. Sir, there is a Romulan Republic vessel here as well. They are hailing us.
Enjoy your interactions with the Tal Shiar. Had you chosen to support us on the surface, I am sure we would be able to assist you. However,
oh, really?
Your actions are making me reconsider our alliance. I must return immediately to headquarters to make a full report on your plight. Best of luck.
And see, now Republic is pissed at me. Thank you. Defeat Romulan vessel. Okay. Where is it? Oh, wow. Okay. And it fired torpedoes right away. Better shields. Nah, I can defeat it. No problem. But yeah. That was unnecessary. I did not expect Republic to be so pissed actually. Well, maybe it's that specific captain. Like, I don't think the town would... he would not agree, but... he follows Vulcan teachings, so... I think he would understand if I explained it to him. Detan is the leader of the Romulan Republic. Yeah, now that I know where the colony is located, I'm actually reconsidering my choice. But still, I think I did what I thought was right. Great. Another ship destroyed. Another diplomatic crisis. And now the Empire is pissed at us as well for destroying second ship. Republic is pissed at us because we sided with the Empire. Sir, I recommend we cross the shield barrier and exit the system before Tal Shiar reinforcements arrive. Agreed. Let's make it so. Yeah. Fly faster. Way faster. We need to leave the barrier, the blockade. Can we? Yes, we can. Before we leave. Thank you. Okay. Warp to Warrenut. Are you ready to set course for Warrenut? Yes, very not. Virinat, if I'm not mistaken, is starting zone for Romulan captains. We have arrived in the Virinat system. Sensors are detecting no signs of activity in the system, not even satellites. For a once populated world, the sensor's silence is eerie. Set course for the planet. We will be also scanning some debris.
Scanning in progress.
Sir, this debris appears to be from a Romulan vessel. It's old, but it looks like some heavy energy weapon hits before it was destroyed. You don't normally see battles like this near agricultural colonies. Now, I have to return to my choice a little bit. It might seem cowardly, like I know that how should I put it?
Scanning in progress.
Like you should stand up for what is right and what you believe, but at the same time I think that you should live to fight another day. Like if you also should be a little bit realistic, right? If you decide to die on a hill, if you are alone against the army, okay, but it should stand for something, right? It should... you should be prepared to die, and you should know that you will inspire, like, another army or something like that, to that effect. While... in case of this colony, I don't feel like it would the sacrifice that they would make it would make a difference. Like Republic is still growing on its own, right? And yeah, I don't think I should be discussing this anymore. I think. I wasted enough time on it already. Sir, this appears to be a debris from a vessel of unknown configuration. However, the energy signatures conform to the limited information we have about the Alachi. There is not enough here for the ship to have been destroyed, sir. Whatever it was, it probably survived this battle. This could be the mysterious enemy the survivors talked about. Could it be the Alachi? We need more information. Do you know who the Alachi are? We will meet them, if you don't know. I think they did appear in one of the TV shows, but I don't remember them playing a huge role, so you may not be remembering them. I'm detecting a vessel. Wait, there is nothing there. Must have been a sensor echo. Or they cloaked again. Are you ready to beam to the surface, sir? Yes. This place is destroyed, Captain, but the damage is only a few months old. I'm not detecting any humanoid life signs, however there are several insect life forms around the area. We should be cautious. Okay, let's get our weapon out, and I guess we will be killing some insects. Because obviously they are the enemy. Oh! Okay, they be dead, and I'm going somewhere there. The battle here must have been a massive. A massive. If you are a Romulan and you visit this place on a mission like this one, I think you will get decoration item for your ship. I'm not sure if we will get it on Starfleet officer. That's some grisly effect on that corpse. Wow. Although this colonist died of a plasma weapon discharge, her tissue appears to be infected with some kind of fungal spores. The bio readings I'm getting are somewhat similar to some of the readings from the prisoners on Installation 18. I do not believe we have completed Installation 18 yet. But oh well. Alright. The evidence of Elachi involvement is mounting. Take a sample. Alright. I guess I will have to fight everyone. And I think I missed. Yep. No, go away. I like him up with his double pistols. I'm surprisingly never used them, even though it should be cool, right? To use. Maybe I will put it on my one of my tactical officers. Alright. Ah, one more. And now we should be safe to look at that device. I guess it's a beacon. Doesn't look like a crater to me. Ha 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 ha. I think this device is some kind of beacon, but it doesn't conform to any technology I'm familiar with. However, the components seem to match some of the equipment we discovered on Installation 18. We did not go to Installation 18 yet. Get a full scan. Starfleet will want to review our findings. You know what? I think after we complete this... Yeah, I wanted to do it after Cardassian struggle, but I think I should be... Before the vault, I will be doing... But even Taris, I think, is continuation of the story. Oh well. Oh well. Yeah, after we complete Taris, but before we start the vault mission, because that is a different story. We will do Nimbus 3, that's where Installation 18 is. I like that questing zone, I guess you would call it. It's different from regular... episodic content. It's like... you land on the planet and there are a bunch of quests there and you progress through the story on the planet itself, so it's different to what they are doing with episodic content, and I like it quite a lot, and for some reason they haven't done that since Legacy of the Romulus, and I'm really disappointed in that because for real, I like it a lot. scan the crater. This crater was created by an orbital strike from a plasma weapon of Romulan origin. Since it is doubtful that the colony destroyed themselves, it could only have been the Tal Shiar. Or the Republic. Although, yeah, it wasn't Republic, but let's not jump into conclusions. Sir, I'm detecting a subspace transmission. We can access it at that console over there. Alright, let's go find the console. Also, this place was beautiful in the Romulan starting experience. I'm tempted to create new characters and go through that, but I will not be doing that. Instead, we will wait. I think eventually there will be an event for it, and if there is, then I will create a new character and do that. Like, there are sometimes events that are supposed to attract new players, but it actually is like alcoholist heaven. Because you create a new character and that character earns like increased rewards. And those rewards are then accessible by other characters as well. Like in 5 levels, I think, we will be unlocking all the rewards that I earned from previous events, which should be like new bridge officers, new weapons, new starship traits and all that cool stuff. Welcome guest, we have one message from Empress Sila. Would you like to play it now? Play the message.
Citizens of the Empire, it is with great sorrow that I report the destruction of our colony in the Virenat system by the terrorist insurgents known as the Romulan Republic. I believe most of the residents of Virenat were loyal subjects of the Empire who were unaware of the terrorist cell hidden amongst their homes and families. Their deaths are a tragedy. When the Tal Shiar attempted to remove the insurrectionists and save Virenat and its people, the Romulan Republic destroyed the entire colony rather than submit to the lawful authority of my forces. I grieve for the loss of innocent life. Rest assured that those responsible will be found and punished for their crimes against the Romulan people. Virenat will not be forgotten.
I'm getting some unusual energy readings, similar to the ones we received from that strange beacon. Oh! Drones! But I think those are Elachi drones. Now, I should be retracting my statements that Romulan Star Empire is like Nazis. Because I feel like Nazis would flat out say that, yeah, we did that. Because they were Jews or whatever. But Tal Shiar is all about misinformation. So I don't know. Like maybe Korea. Today's Korea. I think they have like they are controlling information what their citizens are receiving. Maybe they don't. Who knows? I don't know. Look, people, I'm here to shoot at pixels. Captain, a ship from an unknown configuration has decloaked and is arming weapons. Recommend you and the away team return to the agitated crane 1 immediately. Beam up. It was a scout ship, Captain. We drove it off, but I'm expecting reinforcements any moment. Acknowledged. And here we go. And those are Elachi. And they be jumping and sending boarding parties. Damn it, I think. Fly away faster. And Elachi torpedoes as well. They are dangerous. I know this because I actually have them on one of my characters. Can I make my way? No, I think we will be boarded. Can I actually do something like this? Yes, I can, and it worked. Now, boarding party, what it does, it doesn't actually, like... you don't get to fight off borders, but... it gives you a debuff. I think it destroys your... Bridge Officer's ability to use abilities. Okay. And this we should avoid as well because it does massive damage. Should I be concentrating on the escort or maybe that other... Another boarding party, damn it. More energy to weapons. And actually, let's get boost to weapons as well. Oh my fucking god. They don't give up! Heal the shields. I have that chip on one of my Romulan characters, and I like it a lot. And even I even have some of them of their weaponry. I think I have like 2 out of 3 pieces of the set, which are hard to get because they are from sort of paid content. Like you have to purchase it with regular monies. No, go away from me. No. And they have even torpedoes now. I'm surprised that boarding parties are actually like flying off and not directly into me. Because they should be like torpedoes and navigating right into my face. Let's switch to shields, I think. Because we are having serious issues with shields. And it jumped away. Okay, destroyed. That took way too long for my taste, but they are dead. Captain, we are receiving a priority subspace transmission from Starfleet Command. Do you want me to put it on the main view screen? Yes.
To all Starfleet vessels, our allies in the Romulan Republic are under attack by the Tal Shiar. All combat-ready vessels are ordered to report to New Romulus immediately. Individual orders to follow.
Open a channel to Admiral Tenai.
Thank you for responding so quickly. Your orders are to rendezvous with Battle Group Phi at Virinat and proceed to New Romulus to reinforce our vessels there. The battle is already underway.
We are on our way, and I think it will be a different mission. No? What is going on?
Glad to have you here. Let's get to New Romulus.
Oh, right. Here. Oh no, we will be actually warping to New Romulus. Okay. I did not expect that. So this is actually quite a long mission.
We are grateful beyond words for your help. You have arrived in the nick of time. New Romulus does not have the developed orbital defenses necessary to repel such an attack, and Admiral Kerouac is calling for as many ships as possible to defend the planet. The flotilla protecting the planet has been pushed back by the enemy assault. They are at their final line now. They need your help.
See, they need Federation to protect themselves. They cannot protect colonies. Battle stations.
Glad you could join us. Concentrate fire on their command ship.
Yeah, okay, so this is going to be hard a fight. Because the command ship, I think, can only take damage after it fires, like, serious attack. Like that one. Also, it is very poorly targeted. Is that him? Yeah. Ah, no, he takes some damage here as well. Okay. So the way I defeated the ship before was waiting for him to drop the shield after that huge attack, and then ram several high yield torpedoes into his throat. But we can basically the same way we fought what do you call it, Doomsday Device, right? But it is healing even. Oh fucking god. Ow. I was convinced I was far away from that. Yeah, okay. Okay. So we have a serious problem here. As you can see, it goes back to full health. This is because there is a healer there. Now, I know how this battle works, and I know that that healer is respawning. I don't think I have actual damage output to defeat it, but we will try. And this is going to be poop. We don't have that much allies there, I don't think. Yeah, see, new ships warping in. So I can't actually kill everyone in order to fight him. Sorry. Although maybe if I drag him like far away from everyone else. You should die. Also, I don't think I need shields, I need weapons. Striker shuttle. Yeah, okay, so it is slowly following me, I feel like. So maybe I will be able to drag him, like guide him away from that huge fleet. Come on. Are you still following me? Yeah. Okay, so now I should be able to... Although still I should not be like getting anywhere close to that group. So I should be doing these strafing runs on him. Oh! And he sped up a little bit. Great. He does summon shuttles, but I can deal with shuttles. Right? With high yield torpedoes as well. Okay. I'm not doing any damage to him. Like, I'm doing something, but at the same time it's like... Yeah, he will heal from that very easily. I don't think I can destroy it, guys. Ninety-eight. 100. Yeah, he just has passive regeneration stronger than my... But it almost looks like my allies are destroying the ships, so they will actually help me. Okay, should I try to get there? Or am I just too far away to see all the enemies there. Yeah, I think I'm just too far away to see enemies. There are still warping in. Okay, what can we do? He's doing more damage to me than I'm doing to him. Maybe if I... I'm considering maybe if I die while hugging him, like that would do some serious damage. But no, I don't think so. But his shields are failing. Okay. Now explode on him. 1%. Okay. So that tactic does not work. There it is. And we cannot kill everyone here. I don't think so. I don't know. Well, there is Federation Brigade helping us. Sort of. So maybe. Okay, let's try it again with the help of our Federation friends. Let's get it here. His shields are failing. Like, I think eventually we could make it happen. Maybe. Probably not at all. Oh my god, this is going to be a very long video. Let's time it maybe. 56, is it? Yeah, I think it's 56. Ow. More weapons. Come on. Come on. Come on. Let's actually change to shields. Take it. 91! 90! 80! No, it's healing again. Concentrate the shields there. Come on. More shields. More shields. They probably should be destroying those adds, but... Okay, no. I cannot tank. Come on. He's healing. And my shields are gone again. Yeah, this is not happening. I need the help of some ships from NPCs, but they are way too far away. Right shield failing. And my shields are not working out at all. Well, that Federation Brigade is still at it, but I don't think it deals that much damage. Yeah, no. Come on. Heal up. Okay. Let's go back here. And let's actually try to first destroy the ships, even though new ships are warping in. I don't know why. Where is that frigate? Like, I should be able to destroy smaller ships. And maybe that will... Let's see, new ships are warping in. Those are like the only ones that I can destroy. Come on, die. Die faster. This, I believe, battleship is a healer. Okay, let's focus on frigates. Frigates we can actually destroy. So my logic here is if I destroy enough ships, and the new ships do not warp in, that I will actually be... That I would have... But no, as I kill it, here is another one just warping in. Okay, let me think. And I have been boarded, great. Okay. Come on. Oh. It doesn't even destroy the shield, like... Go away! This is very poorly optimized. Hold on. Hold on. We do have plasma torpedo launcher. Yeah, I don't care about those borders right now. We do have plasma torpedo launcher, so let's do that. What combat? Oh my fucking god. Can you please die? Please die faster. You are a disgrace to dying ships. Okay. Now. I want to put in this torpedo. And on, yeah, for some reason we have the slotted traits, and we cannot slot them in here in combat. Not combat, but like this game is so buggy. On stations, let's switch to Caroline. She has high yield torpedoes. And let's fly back to the battle, which is taking place somewhere there. And hopefully with high yield torpedoes I can do some damage. Are you the command ship? It has some debuffs, like someone is actually fighting it. Let's do hail torpedoes. Now the problem with high yield plasma is it is slow moving. But I can do that as well. Okay. So yeah, we need torpedoes for this ship. And more than that, we also need other allies to attack it. As you can see, they are attacking it now, and it is actually doing some damage. Okay, so now we can destroy it. And see, it is destructible, and I think someone will intercept it before it goes all the way to him. Oh, no! It worked! Perfect. Okay. Now it will die. Finally. And I think now we can destroy everyone else. Right? Surely. Come on. Yeah, as you can see, torpedoes do massive damage, so we should probably... So yeah, we will not be doing beam bolt. And I think we are actually done here. And we shouldn't be killing everyone. We just have to answer the hail. Control craft, that is annoying, so let's destroy it. Yeah, I think we have to get away from the battle to... So we are not in combat, so we can answer the hail and just depart the system. I think everyone is taken care of. Those guys, so that it is fine. The mission is basically completed. This is just cleaning up a battle. And I'm not even sure if it can be cleaned up. I think more will be warping in anyway. But no, actually they are dying. So yeah, okay, let's finish it. Alright, everyone is dead. Okay. Let's answer the hail. I apologize for the length of the mission. I was really hoping that we could work without torpedoes, but I think it's not possible. Like, I thought that with enough beams we will just be doing enough damage there, like, because to fire torpedo we have to face the ship, so we lose those two attacks from what do you call it, aft weapons. Yeah, from aft weapons. So I felt like if I was not going to rotate constantly to fire torpedoes, that I would have consistent damage that will eventually add up to that spike damage from torpedoes, but yeah, no. We actually need torpedoes on the ship. Sir, we are being hailed by the Romulan Republic.
On behalf of the Romulan Republic, thank you for your assistance today. You have saved our new world from destruction. We cannot begin to repay these deeds you have performed today, but know that your names will go down in history.
We were honored to be of service. So, this is the end of the mission, and I wonder what the colony actually decides. It looks like we are done here, sir. Are you ready to depart the system? Yes. Please do depart. This was painful. But we do get some...
The Romulan Republic extends their sincere gratitude for your assistance in saving their homeworld.
Wonderful rewards.
We now know the race you encountered there is called the Alachi, and they are the Tal Shar's new allies. From what you found on Virinat and what they tried to do at New Romulus, I'd say that whatever they're doing, it's not in our best interests. Alt, from what you found on Virinat and what they tried to do at New Romulus,
wow.
I'd say that whatever they're doing, it's not in our best interests.
Yeah, let's repeat that.
The Republic is continuing to search for clues to reveal what exactly is happening to the people being abducted by the Alachi. You, however, may be set to a different task.
So this is installation 18. We will look into that. Now, plasma beam array with better accuracy. Should I be getting better torpedoes? I'm considering it, but at the same time, I don't want to prioritize torpedoes. That's first. And second, I don't like plasma torpedoes. I like it on my Romulan. I have full plasma gear there, but it has destructible projectiles, and when there is a huge battle, a bunch of stuff is going on, those projectiles will probably not find the target. So I will be looking into something like quantum torpedoes or phaser torpedoes, something like that. Yeah. So let's take beam.
Congratulations,
I know this mission has been long, but bear with me. This is Mark 2. Mark 2, Mark 2. So let's slot it in here. We do need it desperately. And let's look at the levels up. Better hull capacity. And we still are not fully... how much did we spend? 6, 12. So 3 more till 15. So I will be getting hull restoration probably. Or no, shield capacity. Or no. Shield restoration. Eh? Because engineering does have some shield restoration powers. And even one of my, like, rotate shield frequency, which is shield regeneration. Uh-huh. Or we go to the defensive maneuvering, even though I said I don't expect it to be that good. But no, that would mean we are... Yeah, let's get into hull restoration. But should we though? I don't like it. How much do... You know what? Off screen I will count how much do we need to unlock all the stuff in the engineering. And if we can get that with just... this stuff without going into hull restoration, I will look into science and maybe tactical. Anyway, I hope you enjoyed the video. If you did, leave a like, write a comment, subscribe to the channel, share it with your friends. Again, I apologize for my like history lessons, my cowardly view on the colony, and my long fight with the Alachi command ship. You are a real hero if you stuck up to the end. I do appreciate it. Thank you. And I will see you next time. Agitated Crane, signing off.